So what is a sign? Sign means signed binary numbers. What is a representation of sign?
Symbol.
Symbol. Symbol means which symbol we are using? Signed. So today we are going to discuss signed binary numbers. Signed binary numbers. Okay, signed binary numbers means, so actually signed means whether it is a positive sign or negative sign according to number system, whether it is a positive or negative. So that is a signed. Signed means whether it is a positive sign or negative sign, right? So positive integers can be represented as unsigned numbers. So positive integers can be represented as unsigned numbers. However, you have to represent negative integers. We need a notation for negative values. We need a notation for negative values. So positive integers can be represented as positive integers. Positive integers can be represented as unsigned numbers. Unsigned numbers. So whereas, however, we can use negative numbers, we need a notation for negative values. Here, the convention is to make a sign. So actually, you know that plus and minus. Whereas in the binary number system, the sign bit plus, so the sign bit positive is nothing but zero. The sign bit is negative is nothing but one. So signed binary numbers, here the convention is to make sign bit is zero, it is for positive. Sign bit is one, it is for negative. Is it clear? In signed binary numbers, we will use a zero and one. Zero is nothing but positive and one is nothing but negative. Okay. So the user determines whether the number is signed or unsigned. The user can determine whether the number is, for example, I will give 57. So it is, you can see this number, you can say it is a positive number, right? The user determines whether the number is signed or unsigned. Okay, so this is an unsigned number. So this is a positive integer. Whereas if the binary number is signed, then the leftmost bit represents the sign and the rest of bits represents the number. For example, here I will write one value. 1001. So this number indicates what the number, this one? In the decimal digit, what is this number equivalent decimal digit?
Nine.
Nine. So if the binary number is signed, so this is nine. The binary number is signed means then the leftmost bit here, you can leftmost bit represents the sign. For example, I can make this one as zero. So the user can determine this. The leftmost bit represents the sign. So zero is nothing but here positive. If it is one, means it is a negative. Then this value indicates that plus nine, right? Is it clear or not? So here 1001 is the nine. Here the sign is, I will keep the value is zero. The leftmost significant here, I will place zero. Our remaining values are represent as number. So the sign bit of the sign, the string of bits 01001. So here the value can be considered as plus nine. Why? Because this zero indicates as positive. The zero indicates as positive. Whereas the string string of bits.
The string of bits 1 1 0 0 1.
The string of bits 1 1 0 0 1 can represent the binary equivalent. It will be represent the binary equivalent. What is the representation of binary equivalent?
25.
Yeah, 25.
So here the string of bits 1 1 0 0 1 can represent the binary equivalent is 25. When you consider as unsigned number, but you can take the binary equivalent value. What is this one? This one is 9. This one indicates the sign. It is a positive or negative?
Negative.
Yeah, negative. So this will be indicates as -9.
Is it clear what I am saying? So the string of bits 1 1 0 0 1, you can take that. So it is considered, we can represent the binary equivalent of the digit is 25. Where this number is considered as unsigned integer. Whereas you can take the signed binary number system. So this will be indicated as -9. Why? Because the leftmost significant bit as 1. So it will be as negative. And remaining 4 digits are 9. So -9 representation in the decimal is 1 1 0 0 1. Is it clear, ma?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So here the leftmost significant bit indicates as whether it is a positive or negative. But here in this case, it will be represented as negative. Okay, so the leftmost significant bit represents whether positive or negative. So here, 1, it is a negative. In this case, 0. 0 is for positive. So this is the introduction about signed binary numbers. Sign means you can place positive or negative. So in binary number system, 0 is nothing but positive and 1 is nothing but negative. Okay, so here we can discuss 3 representations: sign magnitude representation, sign 1's complement system, sign 2's complement system. Okay, so now we are going to discuss these 3 differences definitions. We are going to discuss sign magnitude representation, sign 1's complement system, sign 2's complement system. The first one is signed magnitude representation. Sign magnitude representation. What is the signed magnitude representation?
Signed magnitude means, what is the magnitude? So in signed magnitude representation, the number consists of a magnitude.
In signed magnitude representation, the number consists of a magnitude.
Here in signed magnitude representation, the number consists of a magnitude and a symbol is nothing but
what are the symbols here? The symbol is nothing but plus or minus.
So signed magnitude representation, the number consists of a magnitude and a symbol, a plus or minus, or we can say as 0 or 1. Okay, so here symbol means plus or minus, or we can take as bit means 0 or 1.
It will be indicate the sign. Okay.
So sign magnitude representation, what the sign magnitude representation means? So the number consists of a magnitude and a symbol means either plus or minus,
or you can take bit means either 0 or 1. It will be indicate the sign. So this is the definition of a sign magnitude representation. Okay. So next, coming to the when arithmetic operations are implemented in a computer, you have to perform the arithmetic operations are implemented in a computer. It is more convenient to use different systems referred to as signed complement system. So you have to perform arithmetic operations in a computer. It is more convenient to use a different system referred to as signed complement system. So mainly we have to use a signed complement system for the purpose of negative numbers. So signed complement system we are mainly using for the purpose of representing the negative numbers. Here the signed complement system can be used as either one's complement system or two's complement system. Either one's complement system or two's complement system. So here we are going to use signed complement system. Why we are using signed complement system is nothing but we are using implementing the arithmetic operations in a computer. It is more convenient to use a different systems referred to as signed complement system. Signed complement system. So for referring the negative numbers, why we are using signed complement system is nothing but for referring the negative numbers. For referring the negative numbers. Okay, for referring the negative numbers, we are using signed complement system. The signed complement system can be either one signed one's complement, signed one's complement representation, or signed two's complement representation. Signed one's complement representation or signed two's complement representation. So the signed complement system can be either one's complement system or two's complement system. But mostly the systems will use two's complement system. Mostly the system will be used two's complement system. Is it clear? What is the differences between signed magnitude and signed complement system now? But a signed magnitude system, here the number consists of a magnitude. Or that we can represent a symbol, sign. Sign means either positive sign or negative sign. That means a bit is either 0 or 1. Whereas you can perform mostly arithmetic operations in your computer, there the signed complement system is used for representing the negative numbers. The signed complement system can be divided into, categorized into two types. Either it will be used one's complement representation or two's complement representation. Most of the systems can be used as a two's complement system. Is it clear? And I will tell one example neatly you can understand. So for example, consider the number 9. Consider number 9. For example, we can consider number 9. We can consider number 9 represented in binary with 8 bits. We have to take the number 9 represented with 8 bits. Represented with 8 bits. So take the example, consider the number 9. Represented with number in with binary bits 8 bits. So this 9 is represented in binary with 8 bits. So for example, plus 9. plus 9. How you can write plus 9 with 8 bits? 8 bits undali actual, so you have to represent plus 9 in binary with 8 bits. So what is the 9 value? 1001, right? So these are the 4 bits. Remaining 4 bits are also 0. In the leftmost significant bit, I will place 0. Why? Because this is the positive. So this is the representing the sign bit of 0 in the leftmost significant bit, followed by the binary equivalent of 9, which gives the value 00001001. Okay, so for this 9, so there is only one way to represent plus 9. Okay, so there is only one way you have to represent plus 9. But there are 3 different ways to represent minus 9. So apart from this plus 9, so this is a one solution. Apart from this, you can give any solution to write plus 9 value.
No,
no, yeah. But in minus 9, yeah, but minus 9, you can represent 3 different ways with 8 bits. So there are 3 different ways to represent minus 9 with 3 bits, sorry, with 8 bits. So what are the those representations? The first one is signed magnitude implementation, that is signed magnitude level representation, signed magnitude representation. And the second one is signed ones complement representation, signed ones complement representation. And the next third one is signed twos complement representation. Signed twos complement representation. So there are 3 different ways to represent minus 9. The first one is signed magnitude representation. The second one is signed ones complement representation. The third one is signed twos complement representation. So what is the signed magnitude representation for minus 9? What is the signed magnitude representation for minus 9? So actually,
double one, double zero.
No, with 8 bits, right? So normally 1001 is the 9 value. Yes. So remaining 4 bits or we can place as 0. But this is a sign magnitude. The leftmost significant bit is nothing but either 1 or 0 here. The leftmost significant bit.
1, ma'am.
Yeah, 1. So here it will be 1. So minus 9 value in sign magnitude representation is 1000001. Is it clear? In sign magnitude representation, normally in the 9 value, plus 9 value is in 8 bits representation, 00001001. Whereas in sign magnitude representation, the leftmost significant bit is 1. Why? Because this is the minus. So for negative means, we can place 1. For positive means, we can place as 0. The leftmost significant bit, we can place as 1 means the number is negative. We can place as 0 means the number is positive. Is it clear? This is the sign magnitude representation. The next one is signed ones complement representation. Signed ones complement representation. Actually, what is the 9 value? 8 bits, 00001001, right? Here it will be take a signed ones complement. And that means you can take plus 9 value and perform that ones complement, then you will get a minus 9 value in signed ones complement. Okay, so then what is the value? Here in signed ones complement, in signed ones complement, minus 9, how you can, minus 9 is obtained means, so minus 9 is obtained by complementing all the bits of plus 9, indicating the signed bit. Including the signed bit. So how you can get signed ones complement means, so in minus 9, in signed ones complement for minus 9, it is obtained by complementing all the bits of plus 9, including the signed bit also. Then you will get the minus 9 value in signed ones complement. Then what is the value for signed ones complement minus 9?
Double one, zero, double one, zero.
Right? Is it clear now? Signed ones complement. The next one, signed twos complement representation. So what is that for signed twos complement representation? The signed twos complement of minus nine is obtained by taking the twos complement of positive number 9, including the sign bit also. Okay, the signed twos complement representation of minus 9 is obtained by taking the complement of positive plus 9, including the sign bit also. Then what is the signed twos complement of minus 9?
Double one, zero, triple one.
So already you've got the ones complement result. Then you can simply add plus 1 for this result. So it will be double one, zero, triple one. So this is the minus 9 value in signed twos complement representation. Is it clear? The differences minus 9 can be represented in three ways. One is sign magnitude representation, signed ones complement representation, signed twos complement representation. So whereas minus 9 we can take sign magnitude representation, here minus 9 is obtained from plus 9 by changing the sign bit in the leftmost significant bit, that is from 0 to 1. That is a sign magnitude representation. Coming to the signed ones complement, in signed ones complement, minus 9 is obtained by complementing all the bits of plus 9, including the signed bit also. Coming to the signed twos complement representation, minus 9 is obtained by taking the twos complement of plus 9, including the signed bit also. So by these three ways, we can represent any negative value. Here we will take only one example, that is minus 9. This minus 9 can be represented by these three ways. Otherwise, you can take any negative number that will be calculated by using these three ways. That is sign magnitude, sign ones complement, sign twos complement. Is it clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. The next, we can take one table that is signed binary numbers. You can construct the table and tell me what is the value in signed twos complement, signed ones complement, and signed magnitude representations. First, I will write positive numbers. Then I can write negative numbers. So take one, draw one tabular column. So that is decimal value, decimal values. And the next one, signed 2's complement representation. Signed 2's complement representation. And signed 1's complement. And the last one is signed magnitude representation. Signed magnitude representation. So I will add the values. +7 inch, +7, +6, +5, +4, +3, +2, +1. Okay, so here +7 value. So these are all are common. Why? Because negative numbers only we can represent three ways. That is sine 2's complement, sine 1's complement, sine the magnitude representation. But here we are representing all our plus values, right? Then values are common in all the cases. That means 0, 1, 1, 1. Here also 0, 1, 1, 0, 1. And here 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. Here +5. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. Next 4. 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0. Here also 0, 1, 0, 0. Next 3. 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1. Next 2. 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0. Next 1. 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1. So why we are writing same common binary values in sine 2's complement representation, sine 1's complement representation, and sine magnitude representation means all these values are positive. So positive value can be represented only one way only. Okay, that's why here all values are same. But according to previous discussion, -9 can be represented as three ways. One is sine 2's complement, sine 1's complement, and sine magnitude complement. Sorry, sine magnitude's representation. Okay, by these three ways, we can mention minus values. Is it clear? So these are the positive. And I will write negative. That means -1, -2, -3, -4, -5, -6, -7. So tell me what are the values for -1 in sine 2's complement and sine 1's complement and sine magnitude representation. So here, one value. What is the one value? One value. 0, 0, 0, 1, right?
0, 0, 1.
But you can take sine 2's complement. So 0, 0, 0, 1. So that is 1's complement means 1's complement for this number is 1, 1, 1, 0, right?
0, 1, 0.
Whereas 2's 1, 1, 0. Whereas 2's complement is
1's
complement. Yeah, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1. So sine 1's complement is 1, 1, 1, 0. Sine magnitude representation. Sine magnitude representation.
0, 0, 0.
Sine magnitude representation.
0 0 0.
So actually, one. The no sign magnitude means. Yeah, very good. 1 0 0 1. So sign magnitude means here I will represent minus 1. So one value is 0 0 0 1. But the leftmost significant bit will indicate the sign magnitude. That is whether it will be positive sign or negative sign. If the positive sign means 0, if it is a negative sign means you can place here 1. So minus 1 value in sign magnitude representation is 1 0 0 1. Okay, next you can tell me -2. -2.
1 0 1.
-2. 2's complement.
1 1 1.
1 1 1. No.
1 1 0.
Yeah, very good. 1 1 0. 1's complement.
1 1 0 1.
Yeah. The sign magnitude.
1 0 1 0.
Yeah, 1 0 1 0. For 3. 1 1 0 1, and here 1 1 0 0, here 1 0 1 1, right? For 4, here -4 value is 1 1 0 0, 1 0 1 1. Next, 1 1 0 0. Next, you can take -5 value. 1 0 1 1, 1 0 1 0. And here 1 1 0 1. You can take -6 value. 1 0 1 0, 1 0 0 1. And next one is
1 1 0.
Like this you can calculate the values. Next, -7. 1 0 0 1. Here 1 0 0. And here 1 1 1 1. Yeah, so by this way we can construct the signed binary numbers. So negative numbers can be represented by 3 ways: sign 2's complement, sign 1's complement, and sign magnitude representation. Is it clear? Okay. So next class we discuss some examples, that is arithmetic addition, arithmetic subtraction, by using these signed binary numbers. In next class we will continue. So up to now, today class, you have any doubts?
No, ma'am.